Hi there. In this quick and easy video, you're going to learn how to turn an email signature created inside of Canva into a fully functional HTML signature using Gemini 2.5 and Bybrand. Now, this process is straightforward and ideal for ensuring your signatures remain clickable and compatible with email clients. So let's go ahead and get started. So the first thing that we want to do is we want to create the signature inside of Canva. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to select this visually appealing three-column template for professional emails. Now, what we can do is we can quickly customize this inside of Canva. So I can increase the font size for better visibility. I can remove this green block at the bottom since that doesn't match any of my branding. Or if I wanted to, I could change the color of it. And now, once that signature is all set up and ready to go, I can go ahead and I can download it as an image. Now, once we have that downloaded, the next thing we want to do is we want to convert this image into HTML using Gemini 2.5, okay? Now, this ensures that your signature will be compatible with all email clients, such as Gmail and Outlook and so forth. So we upload the image, and then inside of Gemini, we enter the following prompt. Please, can you convert this email signature created on Canva, which is an image only, to HTML using table. Perfect. Now, after submitting that prompt, we're going to give it a minute while Gemini generates the HTML code for you. Okay. Now, keep in mind that you can also use tools like ChatGPT or Grok for this same task. But today, we're just using Gemini as an example. Now, once Gemini finishes, we're going to copy that generated HTML code. And once we have that copied, we're going to head over here inside of our Bybrand account. All right. Now, Bybrand is a specialized platform for professional email signatures. So we're going to go create a brand new signature and we're going to choose to create it with our own HTML. Then we're going to paste the HTML code generated by Gemini into Bybrand's HTML editor. And then we're going to click on preview. Now, what you'll see here and you'll likely notice is that the images need updating since they were generated directly by Gemini. Now, to quickly adjust this, what we're going to do is we are going to click on each image that needs replacing. Then we have a few different options. We can select a new image directly from Bybrand's image gallery. So we can upload a brand new image from our computer. We can choose icons from Bybrand's gallery or other images from their gallery. Now, once we have that selected, we go through here, we update the different logos and the different icons. We can also adjust the font sizes. Bybrand's editor simplifies this entire process. So what I can do is I can simply select the text that I want to modify. Then I click on the HTML code button to jump directly to that relevant part of the code that I highlighted, which makes it so much easier to edit exactly what I need to edit inside of the signature. So we can change the font size of this, we can change the text itself, whatever we want to do, okay? Now, once we have the images and the fonts updated, our HTML signature is ready for us to use. So we wanna make sure that we save that and then we can preview and see exactly what it looks like. Now, for teams with multiple members, what you can do is you can quickly duplicate this signature. So simply click on Duplicate Signature, the button inside of Bybrand, and then we can easily personalize it for each team member. Then we can return to the signature list and see all of the signatures organized and ready for us to use. Finally, we can click on Copy Signature to insert it directly into Gmail or Outlook. This is quick, it's easy, and it's efficient. And there you have it. Now, compare the original signature that we created inside of Canva with our new HTML version. It's professional, it's functional, and it's fully integrated with your corporate email. If you enjoyed this tutorial, give it a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe to the channel for more practical tips just like this. I'll see you in the next video.